Hi, 4-H garden campers. I heard you love gardening and you want to learn a lot about plants. We are here at the Field and Fork Student Gardens at the University of Florida campus. This is an amazing garden, and I think we're going to go take a look around. My name's Wendy Wilber. I'm the State Master Gardener Coordinator, and I'm going to teach you a few things that are happening in this garden. Hi, 4-H campers. We're back at the Field and Fork Garden, and today we're going to talk about pollinators and the pollinator garden. And you can see I'm surrounded by beautiful flowers, and we have lots of bees and butterflies and bumblebees here. But I wonder if you know what pollination is. Pollination is the transfer of pollen from the anther of one flower to the stigma of the same flower or another flower in order to exchange genetic material. And pollination is really important to produce vegetables, fruits, seeds, and keep the whole life cycle going. Pollinators are responsible for 2/3 of the world's food production. If we didn't have pollinators, we wouldn't have watermelon, we wouldn't have zucchini, we wouldn't have all the different fruits and vegetables that you eat. It really is so important. So here at the garden, they planted tons of flowers that attract pollinators so they can come in and take care of the pollination of the vegetable and fruit crops here. Now this one is a salvia that's a favorite with bees and butterflies, especially bumblebees. We've talked about how important pollinators are to our food systems and to our backyard gardens. So what can you do as a 4-H gardener to help protect pollinators and attract them to your landscape and garden? Well, one of the best things you can do is to plant beautiful plants that attract pollinators and are native or well adapted to our landscape and environment. This is one of my favorite ones, our blue salvia. This is a wonderful one for bringing in bumblebees. Our yellow daisy is native. That's a rosin weed, which is fantastic for attracting honeybees. And you can see the beauty berry, which is another native plant that has got beautiful little white flowers in the spring that really brings the bees in. Another one of my favorites, sometimes we even see on the side of the road, is the giant ironweed with this beautiful purple flowers, about almost 8 feet tall. Behind us we have the plum tree, and these produce a lot of white flowers in the spring. Look, there's a bumblebee right now on this purple salvia, so this really brings in a lot of great bees and pollinators. And the porterweed, this Florida native porterweed, is excellent for butterflies, for bees, for wasps, and for other small beneficials and pollinators. This is a great plant for your yard. This is our native firebush. This is a terrific plant for attracting bees, butterflies, and even hummingbirds, which is another pollinator, to your garden. Pentas is a beautiful plant that brings in bees, butterflies, as well as hummingbirds, and they are wonderful pollinators to attract to your backyard as well as your veggie garden. It's important to have native plants, but you also want to have a lot of different kinds of plants. And diversity is great for attracting different kinds of pollinators. Certain bees may want a different color. They may like purple flowers and not red, or they may want a flower with a deep floral nectary or throat to it. So you want to provide lots of different types of flowers to bring in those pollinators. The next thing to do in your pollinator garden is to not use pesticides. Pesticides are not good for the pollinators. They can really knock them back. And you want to have the pollinators come in. You don't want to be putting out bug spray that's going to hurt the pollinators. It's also a good idea to leave some bare ground. some open soil, and that is a good spot for the ground nesting bees to make their home. And a lot of gardeners like to use a bee box, a box that's specifically designed to have pollinators make their home. This is one of my favorite pollinator plants. It's a salvia and it's called Wendy's Wish. And since my name is Wendy, I really like this plant. But thinking about pollinators, could you imagine your summer without watermelon or blueberries? Next time you eat watermelon or blueberries, thank a pollinator, because if it weren't for the special bees that pollinate them, you wouldn't be enjoying that taste of summer. So thank you for learning about pollinators. Thank you for protecting pollinators and for planting for pollinators, because I want to remind you that chocolate and coffee are pollinated by insects. So in order to keep Miss Wendy happy, we got to have chocolate and coffee. Thanks, you guys. Hope you have a great day at camp.